Welcome and thank you for joining the webinar today. I'm Amanda Jadrow, the Director of Portfolio Management at TRICOM. As an administrative and financial solutions provider to the staffing and consulting industry, it is our philosophy to be an active member of the staffing industry by staying abreast of the ever-changing marketplace. For that reason, TRICOM was pleased to launch the Industry Insider webinar series designed to share our expert knowledge and resources with our fellow staffing industry colleagues. One of our core values is to build relationships and become a leading resource to staffing and consulting firms nationwide. Our presenter today is Brian Slowick with Green Dot Corporation. Brian is currently the Senior Vice President, Wage and Corporate Payments for the Green Dot Corporation and a Rapid Paycard founder. Brian brings to his role more than 30 years of management, leadership, and entrepreneurial experience. Prior to joining Green Dot, Brian was most recently Senior Vice President of Rapid Paycard for Unirush LLC. From 2003 until it was acquired by Wright Express Corporation in April 2011, Brian was the president and a founder of Rapid Financial Services. Advances in technology have brought a new on-demand pay disbursement platform to the workforce payroll environment. This technology enables employers to empower their employees with the choice of how and when they can access accrued wages. In today's Industry Insider webinar, our guest speaker, Brian, will discuss the unstoppable shift to on-demand pay, including today's job market, employee retention and engagement, next generation payments, and plug and play integrations. By the end of this session, you'll learn about the next generation technology made for today's workforce. If you have questions during the presentation, please utilize the Q&A or chat feature. After the presentation, there will be time for questions and an opportunity for you to give us your feedback on today's webinar by completing a short exit poll. I will turn the floor over to Brian.
Thank you, Amanda. Thank you for such a kind introduction. And we truly value our longstanding relationship with TRICOM and look forward to bringing this new technology to play with your customers going forward. And the title of today's presentation, of course, is Technology is Driving an Unstoppable Shift to On-Demand Pay. And as Amanda stated, what we will be covering today is just an overview quickly of the job market, how employees, in fact, point to benefits as a solution for retention and engagement in recruiting, and the next generation of payments and disbursements through a simple plug-and-play integration. And that leads us into actually just discussing today's job market. But before we get started on today's job market, I want to do something a little privately that normally I would when I'm presenting this in a group audience to the American Payroll Association, American Staffing Association, SHRM, or any of those organizations. We have a collective boo. So let's all boo. Boo! Why are we booing? We are booing because most payroll organizations, or maybe even those of you that are responsible for your entire back office, I can hear Rick Gerke and his team booing right now related to the fact that everybody perceives that this topic is that we all have to move to daily payroll. And that is not what this is about. We will not be covering daily payroll. We will be covering the way that technology empowers your organization to allow for the employee or your associate to access some of their accrued wages while your payroll system and your payroll process essentially remains untouched and the same. We are embedding technology that empowers your employee to have the capability to take money how they want, when they want, but without you having to change your payroll process. So I find that it's very important. I actually learned this from Julianne Blasey, Bittner, was our speaker at the American Payroll Association Congress this year at 2018. and really got everybody to just open their ears and open their minds to the potential that technology can bring in your payroll process that can allow you to stay ahead of the recruiting game. And that really is the aspect of today's job market. The job market, as you all know intimately, because staffing absolutely is the canary in the coal mine. And the Rapid team is very, very familiar with staffing because we were born out of staffing. Before Chris Ruppel and I, who are founders of Rapid Paycard, started Rapid Paycard, we had a construction staffing firm that had 40 offices from Florida to California. And we ended up selling it to a division of Labor Ready, True Blue. The division was called CLP, and they happen to be a customer of ours today. But we're very intimate with the challenges that you all face in staffing. And the fact that a tightening unemployment rate makes it very challenging to fill your job orders, even though your job orders go up in a tightening environment. And it is in many markets significantly less than 4.1%. I was just recently giving this talk in Sioux City, South Dakota last week, and their unemployment rate was 2.2. So it becomes significantly more challenging to get people whenever you're dealing with those aspects of the job market. The other aspect that you're dealing with in today's world is absolutely employees are still living paycheck to paycheck. It is a way of life for the majority of U.S. workers. And I'm going to reference this Career Builder survey where they talk about 70% of U.S. workers live paycheck to paycheck to make ends meet. Nearly 1 in 10 workers is making $100,000+, but still living paycheck to paycheck. More than 1 in 4 workers do not set aside any savings each month. And nearly 3 in 4 workers say they are in debt today. More than half think they will always be, especially those of the newer generations in the workforce because of college debt and et cetera. And more than half of minimum wage workers say that they have to work more than one job to make those ends meet. And why is this important for you to recognize? It's important for you to recognize because with that type of environment, along with the low unemployment rate, is you are always going to be facing some employees that need access to money on an off-cycle basis. And how are some of your competitive environments or employers out there dealing with this? Is Walmart, for one, this year increased their pay to $11 per hour for every employee, also expanded their benefits significantly for both maternity and parental leave, and is allowing access to some of their associates for a one-time bonus of $1,000. They also are one of the first large entities. Walmart is not normally cutting edge. They typically like to follow a little bit behind, but they are offering access to on-demand pay with a toe-in-the-water type of approach where they will allow their associates to access accrued wages 8 times per year. So that's a bit of a toe in the water for one of the largest employers out there. The others that are following right behind it would be some of your big retail, big box outlets out there in home improvement, that being both Home Depot and Lowe's, where there are 80,000 plus seasonal workers for its peak season, which is already in place. They're adding 20% to their workforce. And also, Lowe's said it would add 53,000 temporary staff to its workforce, and they're also increasing their wages and their benefits. So turnover in the marketplace for your regular employer, like the three I just referenced, take a significant toll in the workforce. But within your workforce, in your environment, where the turnover is exceptionally high, versus the regular workforce, industry average for staffing is well over 400% turnover, it can be even more difficult and more challenging, and we understand that. The interesting thing about it is with turnover, regardless of the company, the cost of the work that isn't getting done when the employee is missing is a real challenge. And most of the time, it causes a credibility issue with leadership because somebody has to pick up that extra slack for those missing employees. A loss of that credibility actually is a real opportunity for you in the staffing environment, because that is often the pain that you're able to leverage in order to get a job order out of that particular prospect or client that you have and increase your depth of revenue within that particular client. But again, you've got to be able to accomplish that in an environment that is usually leading to that opportunity existing, which is they can't find somebody to hire. So you have to be able to offer benefits that are more attractive than your very clients that you're trying to place the people with. And that also becomes a challenge as the workforce continues to evolve. And where we really want to focus on in that scenario is that millennials are the workforce. And if there are any millennials listening, this is meant to be a compliment going forward. I know many times you feel as though, I know in our office, the millennial generation feels like they're being picked on. They're not. We have the baby boomers like myself. We're all fading away. And by 2020, millennials will represent nearly half of the U.S. workforce. And the most interesting component of the millennial workforce is that half of them expect to leave their current job within a year. What makes that so intriguing to an old guy like me is that in my generation, my parents used to say the same things that we or others say about millennials, and they said it about the baby boomers, is that you were considered to be a job hopper if you had 3 to 4 jobs in your entire career. Now we're talking about half of all millennials expect to leave their current job within a year. And that has been caused by some of the employers over the last 30 years, where we encourage people to be out looking for new opportunities and taking advantage of new educational opportunities by cross-pollinating across employment and et cetera. That is also an attractive feature of being part of a contingent workforce within your world, and what you offer to your clients is that it may be more attractive as this change occurs to the millennial generation, is that staffing is a more intriguing place for a person to work because they can continue to hone their benefits and their experiences and become more attractive to future employers. Now, how do employers win the competition game out in the marketplace to hire these different employees? And oftentimes you're competing against the very clients that you're trying to staff, is that employees point to benefits as a solution for retention and engagement. And what we're trying to bring to light to you today is that you have technology that can allow for some of those benefits to be available, and that you can customize those benefits so that the loyalty to their employer or to your to you as their employer can be significant. The workforce continues to evolve, and the main thing there is that now there's a new way for you to reduce your payroll costs while offering innovative payment benefits to your changing, ever-changing workforce, which we already described is a very attractive aspect for the employees, so that they can get paid how they want, when they want, and most importantly, where they want the money to go to. And now we're into where we get to talk about the next generation of payments and disbursements. And that is what we really want to focus on is that fintech, which is simply as a abbreviation industry term for financial technology, is making for today's workforce. Where we, as a fintech organization, and Green Dot is a fintech organization based in Pasadena, California, we're publicly traded on the New York Stock Exchange, so a very, very healthy company. You can find us under the ticker symbol GDOT, and Rapid Pay Card and Simply Paid Disbursements Platform are two brands of products that are sold by Green Dot. And thrilled to have the capability to bring all of the power of a large organization and the credibility of having a transparent financial statement so that you know that we will be around in the long term to bear for you. We are able to enable 100% electronic payments with full consent tracking, which is critical to you, and dedicated risk and compliance teams so that you, as whether TRICOM is doing your back office or you are doing it yourself, that you can feel comfortable that we are keeping you out of the Department of Labor's spotlight and that everything is in compliance across every state. But most importantly, we want to drive that employee engagement with the ability for the employee to have early access to accrued wages when they need it through a simple mobile device. Everything that we're doing is being pushed to mobile because most of the millennial generation will tell you that their primary access point of the internet or anything is through a tablet or a mobile device. And so we are powering everything to be accessible not only through the internet, but most importantly through all mobile devices. And why is this important to you? How many times, I know we used to hear it day in and day out, all across our 40 offices all across the country, I couldn't make it today because I don't have a I couldn't make it to the job because I didn't have enough money for gas. I can't make it to the job today because my radiator blew out. I need $20 before I can get it fixed. I can't make it to the job today because I have a flat tire. By the way, boss, can you give me an advance? Those are all the things that we're trying to eliminate from your issues on a day-to-day basis, but allow for the employee to simply fire up their mobile device and have access to monies that they've already earned. And again, this is only monies that they've already earned. This statement here, early access to accrued wages is critical. That means that it's not an advance, it is money that they've earned. We have some folks that have told us that they've accepted a job, gone to orientation, sat through orientation for 3 or 4 hours, and at the end of the orientation, they found out they couldn't get paid for that time that was paid orientation, so they went down the street to take the job at the next place that would allow them to access that money immediately. So that's what we're talking about. And we're talking about a very scalable product that has been in use for many years that is provided by the Green Dot Corporation and through us. It is Simply Paid, but it is hidden behind the application of Uber. Uber integrated the next generation of payments in 2016. As you can read by these quotes, drivers love it. And what I would encourage you to do, if I asked how many of you use Uber, I would expect it's like our public audiences when we ask the question, that it's about 60% of the audience has used Uber. Every time I use Uber, and I used one yesterday, and I used two yesterday, and I'll be using two today in order to get home, I ask the driver, you know, if they take advantage of instant payments. I would say virtually every one of them does, except for the father that is, you know, doing driving instead of throwing newspapers maybe because they're looking to pay for their son's hockey practice or daughter's gymnastics or whatever that might be, and they are never accessing the money except for a very specific item. Most Uber drivers are accessing this access to accrued wages on a daily basis. Uber is the opposite end of the spectrum from Walmart, where we said Walmart allows for their employees to access accrued wages 8 times per year, which is very, very slow, very, just a toe in the water. Uber allows for drivers to access their wages that they've already earned up to 5 times per day. That statement, 5 times per day, usually makes a payroll manager's head want to explode. But the nice thing is that this is all done through technology that allows for the payroll manager to be outside of the loop. All we are requiring is that we have instant access to their time and attendance, and you get to set the rules, and we'll talk about that as we talk about later. Now, of course, Uber drivers are a 1099 employee. They're a little bit easier than the W-2 employee, but many of you have a number of your employees that are in fact 1099 as well, and this can fit in very easily. Also, Uber is a very highly technical organization, and it is Simply Paid is able to be utilized by an API, and in fact, a technical interface that is real time into the application. With what we are talking about for you today, whether it is through a hosted environment at your organization or through Tricom, we are able to provide that same type of technology without you having to make any significant changes to your regular payroll process. Uber drivers absolutely stay more engaged by cashing out their earnings on demand. It goes simply to their existing debit card or to their Go Bank account, which Go Bank account, think a rapid pay card, is what they're able to take advantage of. And they get, the most importantly, is they get to choose any debit card, any bank account, any pay card for this particular platform to pay those fees. And if you also talk to drivers, many times it's to get that first tank of gas after they do that run in the morning, and it allows them to run their business off of wages that they've already accrued. It also allows for the entity to be 100% electronic pay. There is no one that ever receives a check as a driver. Majority of eligible drivers, as I said, do in fact use the instant pay, and it's been used so significantly since 2016 that we have 5+ million instant payments paid out on a monthly basis. And the number of dollars have been significant, well over $4 billion delivered in that time period. Now it is probably, since this slide was done in the beginning of the year, over $5 billion that have been delivered. The world is in fact ready for on-demand payments because Uber and Lyft and other entities like this are becoming more and more of your competition to get people to fill your jobs and your open orders, because it's real easy for a person, if they in fact have a car, to go ahead and just say, okay, I'll drive for, it's better for me to just drive with Lyft or drive with Uber. And why not allow yourself to take advantage of the advances in technology for this drive to the unstoppable shift of on-demand pay and the culture associated with it, so that you can stay as competitive as the nation's largest employers. Businesses need to adopt these modern solutions so that you're not left behind and you're not trying to figure out how to stay more competitive than the guy down the street. But the other aspect is, it's really important for you, because as the canary in the coal mine that staffing is, that you are more competitive than the employer that you're getting orders from, so that you can be more attractive and get to the worker before they can even catch up. And that is the real positive to this particular platform of Simply Paid, and with the rapid pay card that allows you to take advantage of the financial technology so that an employee can be paid to any debit account, regardless of whether it's a credit union, a large bank, a pay card of some nature, as well as for you to have the security and the tracking capability to go along with it. It's easy to send daily files with no complicated integrations in order to move forward with this next generation of payments. It is something that we are working closely with TRICOM and Rick Gerke and all of his team in order to get put in place. And it is a very interesting and simple product, thereby named Simply Paid, to take advantage of. This simple plug-and-play integration allows for those next generation of payments to work seamlessly with any payroll system. We are payroll system agnostic. We are not a payroll system. The technology of Simply Paid just lays on top. It is a disbursement engine. So all we do is finish that last mile to take from your payroll system and be able to allow for the worker to be paid. The employees can pay, employers actually can pay 100% of their workers through this. It can be used for a variety of different things. And most importantly, the worker can decide how, when, and where they are to be paid. This next generation of payments is a complement to any payroll system. Like we said, it does not replace them. The platform integrates with electronic payroll systems to enable that electronic disbursement. And it also, most importantly, which is a competitive advantage of other programs that may be out there, is that it feeds the information back into your payroll system so that at the time that you are doing payroll, you have a line item deduct that shows whether the employee has access to any of the pay, and then their appropriate net is delivered to the employee on payday, and it is reflected in their pay stub. It can be used, the single platform of Simply Paid, for any of the following employer payout needs. Absolutely works for your regular W-2 employee. We already talked about 1099. It is a great option for tips to be paid electronically. Many of our restaurant clients that have casual dining or fine dining or anything associated with tips, including tip jars, have expressed that it is a real challenge in today's environment to take care of tips because so many of the tips are switching from cash to electronic that sometimes they actually find themselves shipping in cash, which is very expensive, to allow for those tip payouts to happen. We can still deliver it all in electronic fashion at the end of the day, and that is what this platform allows. It also allows you an easy way to take care of bonus and education and travel expenses, and most importantly, in some of the more challenging states, such as California, it allows for termination pay, as well as missed pay and corrections. So, a lot of flexibility, a lot of different things that you can take advantage of the Simply Paid platform for. But the most important aspect that we are talking about today is early access to accrued wages, which we call on-demand pay. So Simply Paid on-demand pay, which again is empowering the employee who has that broken radiator to say, I really need $37.50 to get this thing fixed, and I need it now, and I've worked 2 days this week. They go into their mobile app. They're able to see that they have $50 that is available because you set the rules as to how much they can access and how frequent they can do. You have the master control panel, and they can make this request without contacting you, your office, or your staff. And then the monies, once they hit the okay, are easily sent to any of their choices of bank accounts that they set up in the system, which is our system, whether it be a debit card from a bank or it be another pay card or it be the rapid pay card. Early access to accrued wages is disrupting a marketplace that is the check casher world, and there it is a highly desired benefit. And the reason that it continues to be a highly desired benefit is what I stated in the beginning from that Career Builder survey: is current short-term credit products are costly and widely used, so much so that fees and interest paid on an annual basis are well over $50 billion. and you have 19 million households are taking advantage of short-term credit. Short-term credit would be those that are like check cashing environment that offers, you know, an advance or a loan, and tends to be a hamster wheel type of environment that you'd like to help your employees stay away from. Early wage accrual access is considered a financial management tool that does in fact replace those alternatives, also allows for the employee to not fall into those bad habits, and allows for you to be especially competitive versus those gig economy jobs that are out there. And it allows for you to offer your employee without, again, bothering you or your staff to know that that money is available when they need it. They may not necessarily take advantage of it every single day. They may only take advantage of it once per week or once per month, or maybe only two times per year, whatever that may be, but it's always comforting to know that they have access to it when they need it. The opt-in rate for payroll wage advance for persons under 30 is nearly 100%, and total employee enrollment is between 20 and 25% and up when an employer offers this intriguing benefit in order to stay competitive in today's workplace. Payday lending is expected to drop 55% in loan volumes due to the Consumer Financial Protection Board, the CFPB regulations that are coming into play within the coming year. And also, I always think it's a more attractive and comforting approach to do this, where they're simply paying a fee that is less than an ATM transaction to access their monies. Approximately 73 million adults are either finding it difficult to get by or are just getting by financially. So when you get that broken radiator that we've been talking about, it can cause a spiral that really can cause you to cause some of these workers to find themselves in a real bind. 3 out of 10 adults still report that they're either finding it difficult to get by, which is in fact 9%, or they're just getting by, which is in fact 21%. 73 million adults are struggling to some degree getting by. And we would like to provide you with an option that allows for those employees to have a solution and also stay working, because the best benefit out there is a paying job. When you look at this particular chart, which can be a little challenging to read, but what you will be able to see is that the folks that are facing the greatest challenge of financial stress are often those that you are most likely to employ. That is, in fact, single parents, racial and ethnic minorities, and those that live in more rural areas are having the greatest challenges. Also, a key metric for early wage accrual is, in fact, as we said, the 1099 worker. And the 1099 worker, I believe this to be good news for you in the staffing industry, because my belief, especially coming from staffing, is that staffing was really the first gig worker or gig economy out there. And we believe, based upon the numbers, is that the flexibility of the gig economy is an attractive option to the millennial workforce, and working closely with technology will make these jobs even more attractive as it goes forward. And you can see this is the historical growth of the gig economy from 2005 to 2016, and it has been continuing to rise. And I believe that the latest numbers show that it is even rising at a faster rate than it did in those years from 2014 to 2016. So some critical decisions that you need to make when you're offering this access to accrued wages or wage advance or simply paid on demand is that the company must determine who will fund the advance of wages and who will pay the fee to access the funds. There are a variety of models out there. As you can see on the left-hand side of this four-quadrant graphic is that the employer is funding those, where on the top left, the employer is funding the advance and the employer is paying the fee. You may be sitting there saying, we would never do that. And that is where most employers, in fact, do say that they would never do that. But there are some that are, because they're in such a competitive environment that they feel it's well worth their time and money to go ahead and offer that choice. The other aspect is that you have the, on the top right, where the provider, such as us, that Green Dot Simply Paid Rapid Pay Card, would be funding the instant payment, and the employer would pay the fee for the employee to access it. That is something that some of our competitors do. We think it's a real problem because that can actually be considered a loan. And we also think it is a problem because you don't know how credible many of those new providers are in the marketplace. They typically are privately held. They typically are startups, and you, while you wouldn't want to trust your payroll with another company, you don't necessarily want to trust this portion of the payroll with them either. Then you come down below that to the bottom right, where you have the provider, again, somebody like a Simply Paid Rapid Pay Card, is again funding the payment, and the employee is paying access for that money. So similar to an ATM type of fee. And we tend to find that $3 is the cutoff that somebody is willing to, three or below is typically what they're willing to pay on average. But again, you still have that same problem with the provider may not be financially stable. And also we believe it leads to different liability associated with being a lender. So the majority of the players and employers tend to fall into this bottom left-hand quadrant. And this is where we typically play is always on the left-hand side where it's the employer funded. If you're using a pay card today, you may instantly fund some of your pay cards through a disbursement account. It is the same way with this, to where you have an employer-funded disbursement account or a TRICOM-funded disbursement account, depending on if they're doing your back office. And the employee, when they access that to fix my radiator and they make that request through the app, I'm going to elect and agree that I'm taking this advance that is going to be paid, say, straight to my rapid pay card, and I'm going to pay, I'm just picking a number, $3 in order to access that, $40 so that I can pay my $37.50 in order to fix my radiator. So that is actually the way that you have to work through some of the key decisions. And compliance and consumer protection always remains critical when you're dealing with employees' pay. And Department of Labor always takes a close look at these products, and as they become more and more popular in the workforce, they will, of course, collect more and more scrutiny. And we at Simply Paid, Rapid Pay Card, and the Green Dot Corporation always are your partner in staying in advance of that. We have fought aggressively since 2003 to be a compliance leader. And we make that promise to be a solid partner with you so that you can be sure that the product we're delivering to you is easy for your employee to sign up, most importantly has choice for the employee, and is a great user experience. I cannot stress choice enough with your employee, where we continue to say get paid when you want, how you want, and where you want. How and where are the portions of choice? some of the competitors out there in this particular offering are forcing people to a card that is not compliant in a pay card scenario, and it eliminates choice. So we really believe you have some vulnerabilities there. And in our world, we think it is critical that you allow for the payment to be wherever they want, whether it is their bank debit card, their bank account, their credit union debit card, their pay card that they got from some other employer, or they can in fact leverage the rapid pay card that's available today. This is simply the electronification of a process that you've been doing for decades. And we are then empowering technology that allows you to offer those advances in pay on somebody that has already earned them. And we give you a simplistic way to go ahead and accomplish that. So why do you want to do it? Is that first off, it brings great value to you as the employer. It will save you time. It allows for faster payment deliveries, instant cashless payments of all types, including tips, easy integration, efficiencies with a single platform for all payouts. So that is critical to you. What are the values? Other values to you is that you save money. It allows you to have the cost savings associated with becoming paperless across your W-2 and 1099 workers, and avoid fees to execute pay corrections when somebody is asking for a correction on their hours, potential for later funding of payroll upon approval, or a variety of other things that can really come to play for you as the employer, and also allows you the opportunity to delight staff so that you in fact can be competitive in that very aggressive workforce hiring arena that's out there today, and have for the flexibility for employees to be paid to whatever account they want without you having to do a paper check. So let's go ahead and move over. Amanda, are you going to take it over at this point?
Yes, thank you so much for covering this in such great detail. I think you've done a wonderful job of answering, I think, a lot of the questions that are probably circling through people's mind as they're hearing about this electronic on-demand pay. So please go ahead at this time and submit any questions that you have via either the chat or the Q&A feature. And Brian will be happy to walk through some of these things with us. I do have a couple questions that have come in. Brian, can you explain a little bit about the time and attendance system requirement that is needed for this to function, and a little bit more about how that works?
Sure. What it can be is simply a file-based scenario where you have, you know, if you have folks that are reporting their time tickets on a daily basis, and we can set the rules. The most important thing to understand about the Simply Paid platform is that you, as the employer, get to set the rules of when and how the employee can access this this system based upon your capabilities of dealing with time and attendance. So if, in fact, it takes you, say, 24 hours after the person has worked to report their attendance, then we would not allow them access to, you would not allow the employee access through the master control panel to wages until day two or 48 hours after they worked. So you simply give us a file of who the employees are, what the hours that they work, and then we impute based upon a formula that you establish and you agree on how much they can access. Some employers like to say, hey, we'll just simply set it up, they can access $20 a day based on, that's just a flat dollar number. Or you can access a percentage of your pay that's available. But most importantly, Amanda, is that the employer gets to set the rules that work best for their staff.
Wonderful. For a W-2 employee, accrued, if they access accrued wages, at the time that payroll is processed, will the tax burden be the full amount at that point in time?
Great question, and that is a question that still does not have a black and white answer. It is something that you have been providing advances for time in and time out. We are under, and we will stay abreast of it as it goes forward. At this point in time, it is a gray area, and part of what they are doing when they are making the request is they are making a, and I have trouble stating this word, attestation, that they agree that these monies are subject to taxes at the end of the payroll period. That is part of the technology. If the government, just like PayCard has, it just continues to change on a daily basis from state to state, and we will make the appropriate adjustments as those efforts either bear greater access or there are regulations put in place to adjust accordingly.
Thank you. Another question that has come in the staffing industry, what are you seeing as a percent of accrued wages that other staffing companies might be utilizing?
It varies based on the type of staffing that the entity is in. Take my old world of construction staffing, which has actually a higher unemployment or actually turnover rate than average staffing. We used to be well over 600%. They're likely to pick a lower dollar figure, so a flat dollar amount of say that $20 per day that they would allow somebody to access. When you get into say more technical scenarios where you may have a more higher compensated individual, it is likely to be a percentage of pay that they are going to allow the person to access. So it might be 20% of their pay for the day. But the most important thing is that you, as the staffing owner or the person running the system, get to set those parameters based on your needs, and you can adjust them on a monthly basis or annual basis, depending on how you're rolling out the program in order to stay competitive.
Okay, so it can be a percent-based or flat dollar amount are definitely the two different options that can be used.
You can also set it by position. So, for example, take just a direct W-2 employer to where, let's say I'm a restaurant, just because it's easy for everybody to envision this, to where you have the hostess, you have the cook, you have the table cleaner, the busboy, you have the server, and you have the dishwasher. Every one of those positions can have a different availability based upon your choice. For example, when you talk in the restaurant world, you would be surprised, the hardest person to keep employed and one of the most important persons to keep employed is in fact the dishwasher. So they may allow a higher number for the dishwasher on a flat dollar basis, as where with the hostess or the chef, it might be a percentage of pay. Does that help?
It does. Yes, it does. And you actually just covered another question that came in. So thank you for giving a little more detail on that, where you can adjust it, the percentages or the amounts by position. Are you able to do it just by position? Is that the lowest level then of categories?
You can do it by division, you can do it by position, you can do it by, basically it's any way you can slice the cake. We've got it so that you have the controls.
Okay, well, it gives the employer a lot of flexibility.
Correct.
Okay, wonderful. And A couple of questions that have come in are around the fees and how the fees work and who pays the fees. In your slide, you had mentioned $3. Is that what the employee would pay? Is that pretty typical as to what you're seeing to access accrued wages?
So this is the slide. I think you're seeing it right. The green with the green box, the four boxes.
Yes, that's the slide. Actually, hearing on, I took control. So I'll go back to that slide.
Go ahead.
Yep, relation to that.
It's just it's often better to have the visual right there. Perfect.
Okay.
Is that it really the portion that we're going to play on? Some of my competitors play on the right-hand side of that four-box graphic, whether it be the top right or the bottom right. We believe that from a regulatory perspective that that is risky. And we also believe that it's not sustainable, that the provider is, you never know if they're going to have enough money to continue to fund your request by your employees, and it could break them, as well as we believe that that leads to it being a full-blown loan. On the left-hand side, it is purely very much like doing an advance, and we have some on that top left to where the employer is paying for everything. That is always your option, and we have some employers, very few, that are doing that, but if you're in an extremely competitive environment, you may choose that you want to do that. That first off, the monies that are being paid out are in fact your payroll dollars. You're just allowing them to access them a little bit early, but you would also pay the fee. The greater the volume, the lower the fee. So when we talk about, let's use Uber as the example, where it was almost $5 billion on a monthly basis that are processing through, they're paying, the driver of Uber is paying about a dollar in order to access that money up to, and they can do up to five of those a day. And many, many, well over 50% of the drivers do in fact take advantage of that on a regular basis. For a lower volume employer, like probably most of us would be, is you're likely to, we find that the breaking point in that bottom left-hand side, which is where 95% of our customers are going to play, probably 98%, is that it's your wages or your monies that are being funded out, or TRICOMs that are being funded out, and the employee is electing, hey, I want to take advantage of this, just like they would an ATM, that they want to pay the fee to get it early, and it's likely to be based upon volumes around $3. I can tell you once we get above $3, it tends to be more of a pushback from the employee. In other words, it's the cost, an average cost of an ATM transaction they're willing to pay, just so they can have the money.
And for many of our clients, the TRICOM clients that are on the line, TRICOM funds their invoices for them to help meet their payroll. So that would still be an option in this case. If we're in a total staffing admin relationship where they are funding their own receivables, how is it that they would know when someone has accessed their pay early to be able to fund that themselves, or TRICOM to fund it for them?
So the way it works, I'm gonna assume that the person asking the question understands how, say, a pay card works today, or the way the rapid pay card works today within TRICOM. Is that with the rapid pay card, there is a disbursement account that allows for you, for example, if somebody did not, their wages were reported incorrectly. In other words, they didn't hand their timesheet in on time and payday came and they're a full day short, and you want to correct that immediately, is TRICOM today with the rapid pay card has an amount of money sitting in an account that is owned by TRICOM, and is protected with all the banking rules and regulations. It's not a rapid pay card account. And they can access that in order to correct my pay, and it's immediately available on my pay card. Same thing here is that you as the employer would have money sitting aside. It could be $5, it could be $5,000, it could be $50,000, depending on the volume. You also have the capability, whether it be the example that I just laid out or the example that we're talking about now, to wire into the account so that monies are available. But there needs to be some funds there in order for the employee to have access, any employee to have access. So when you set your rules, for example, as $20 per day per employee, and you have it to where you said, okay, I would, the worst case scenario, I want to make sure I have enough money in my account that 100% of those employees accessed it, this is how much I would need. Let's say it was 10, right? And you're allowing $20 per day, 10 employees is what you have. Just for simple math, that's going to say that you need to have $200 in your account every single day. How do we report back right before you run your final payroll? Where, and you get, again, to set the parameters as to when the cutoff is. And many of our best practices for the employer is they'll set it at 24 to 48 hours before the payroll run. The employee cannot access, so you're asking them to wait a day where they can't access their funds. And that we give you the file back. It produces a line item deduct for up just like you would for, say, insurance payments that the employee is making, 401k or anything. And then you run the net, and the net of wages takes into consideration that I accessed $20 early. Does that answer your question, answer the question, Amanda?
It does, yes. That's perfect. Thank you so much. And for anyone working with TRICOM, we will, kind of make this a seamless transition for you and for your staff to be able to access this. We are looking at our first quarter implementation to roll this out to clients and to offer this new technology that we are covering today. Brian, before we close the session for today, did you have any final thoughts or comments that you'd like to share with the audience?
My final comment or thought would be that Kirk Bishop is always available to speak with anybody, and his information is right up there on the screen about moving forward. We value greatly our long-standing relationship with TRICOM and are willing to work with you any way that that you see fit. Also, we have Steve McDonald, who's been in the room with me as we're presenting today. He is the director of channel development for Green Dot and Rapid Pay Card Simply Paid. So thank you again for the opportunity to provide this session, and we look forward to providing more in the future.
Fantastic. Again, thank you for joining us in our webinar today. And Brian, thanks so much for sharing your knowledge on this technology that's driving the unstoppable shift to on-demand pay. We will have a recording of this session available on our website at tricom.com. It's under the Resources tab in the Industry Insider Webinars area. Thank you again for your participation, and watch for information on our next webinar session. Have a great day. Thanks so much.